Electricity rates have reached all-time highs, while the CEOs of the top investor-owned utilities are earning more money than ever. What's going on?
The utilities get away with it. They're laughing year after year. They get away with the same thing. Their profits have soared, but so have electric rates.
We're getting to the point where electricity is becoming unaffordable.
For this episode of Plugged In, I put on my detective hat and sat down with several energy experts to dive into why electricity prices are soaring, who's really cashing in, and why some utilities are wrongly blaming rooftop solar for your rising bills. Before we dive in, hit that subscribe button so you can stay plugged in to clean energy topics. Now, most of you don't need me to tell you that electric costs have risen dramatically in recent years because you're paying for it. The average price of electricity in the U.S. hit a new record high in March 2025, up 35% from 5 years ago. Nearly 80 million Americans are struggling to pay their utility bills, and I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but prices are expected to go up. In the beginning of 2025, U.S. gas and electric utilities either requested or were approved for rate hikes totaling roughly $20 billion.
We're really going to be able to jack up our prices.
These prices are significantly outpacing inflation, and proposed tariffs could make electricity even more expensive. There's a lot to say on tariffs and electricity, but we'll save that for an upcoming episode. Now, there will always be price fluctuations surrounding our energy supply, whether that's coal, gas, or renewables. But it turns out that's not the biggest driver of our crazy prices right now.
And what is it?
I spoke with energy expert Jigar Shah, an entrepreneur and podcaster who was formerly the director of the loans program at the Department of Energy. So he knows a thing or two about electricity and finance.
When you look at your electricity bill, which is what most people care about, right? It's not the generation part that's been going haywire. It's the distribution part that's been going haywire, right? And so distribution used to be 20% of your bill. Today, it's 50% of your bill.
Let's take a look at this real electric bill from Massachusetts. The supply part covers the cost of generating the electricity you use, while delivery is the cost of delivering that electricity to your home. We can see that electricity supply is about $220 here, which is still high, but the delivery charges are nearly $315, or 60% of the bill. So the question becomes, why are energy delivery costs rising?
People are buying all sorts of things that use electricity, whether it's hair dryers or electric vehicles or heat pumps. The utility says, we need to be able to upgrade the distribution grid so that you can do whatever you want. You can turn every single thing on in your house at the same time, and we have to be able to serve you. Well, that bargain is getting way too expensive.
If you have to ask me how much it costs today, you can't afford it.
He's right. Americans are using electricity like never before, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Home electrification is great for our planet and our health. Go watch episode 2 if you haven't already, and you'll see what I mean. The problem is, much of our power grid was built back in the 60s and 70s, back when people had one TV, no computers or internet, and only 12% of homes had air conditioning.
And so there are necessary upgrades that are needed, especially as climate risk and natural disaster risk are rising.
That's economist Jesse Bushbaum, and he also brings up the valid argument of a changing climate. Our record hot summers and historic freezes put a bigger strain on the grid, like we saw with that 2021 ice storm in Texas that left millions of people powerless in freezing temperatures for days. To prevent these events from happening, utilities say we have to pay for those upgrades.
It's needed to expand the grid as well, both in the generation sense, but also to build the poles and wires that will transport the power, which is driving electricity prices higher.
Okay, so we are using more electricity than ever, and our grid is old and needs upgrades, so we can't really be mad at our skyrocketing electric bills. Or can we?
Utility spending has been out of control for years and years and years.
Brad Huebner and his team at the California Solar and Storage Association, or CalSA, hired an independent economist to look into 20 years of utility rate case filings in the state. They published a 34-page report that called out utilities for overspending and overcharging ratepayers.
You know, every 3 years they come into their general rate case and they say, we need to spend $8 billion next year for fixing and expanding the distribution grid. And the regulators look at that and they're totally outmatched. They're unable to say, no, you don't really need to spend that much money for safety and reliability.
While Brad's specifically talking about California, utility overspending and overcharging is a nationwide issue. RMI recently released a report highlighting how utilities have been investing money into small projects within their territories. The projects involve strengthening transmission lines, which are those high voltage wires that carry electricity from power plants to your city or town. Now, the report says these small local projects have very little oversight from state and federal regulators, earn the utilities guaranteed profits, and cost us ratepayers way more than if they were to invest in bigger regional projects, ones that would require a more thorough review process. Report co-author Claire Wehner gave Canary Media this analogy. Regional transmission planning is like driving on a toll road with all the checkpoints, while local approach is like driving on a road with no speed limits. Utilities can build as much as they want.
I do what I want, when I want, and if I don't want to answer your questions I ain't got to.
Here's some proof in the pudding. A 2024 analysis by Grid Strategies found that transmission project spending hit an all-time high in 2023, but only 55 miles of new transmission lines were added that year, compared to a record 4,000 miles added in 2013. Yet our electric rates were about 20% cheaper in 2013.
We authorized the utilities to spend a lot of money, and they haven't spent most of that money yet. It is growing. And, you know, it's really criminal. In some cases, we've paid them to make upgrades and fix transmission towers, and they haven't done it.
And now, while millions of Americans are unable to pay their monthly bills, a recent report shows the CEOs of the largest publicly owned utilities are earning more than ever. We're talking between $17 and $33 million a year.
We make the rules, pal.
I also want to come back to another thing. Some utilities say that homes with solar panels are making your bills go up, a theory called the solar cost shift. The idea is that if solar homeowners are making their own power, utilities make less money. But solar homeowners still have to use the grid sometimes, so the utility raises everyone else's rates to compensate. And it sort of paints solar panel owners as freeloaders.
Freeloader.
Excuse me?
There is some cost shift. I think it's far smaller than what people are suggesting. But I think the bigger problem is that, you know, it feels bad when your bills are going up and a bunch of people that have the means to put solar on their roof are getting a good deal and all of your neighbors are not getting a good deal.
It does feel bad. Most of us can clearly see charges on our bill related to solar panels, even if we don't have them. So utilities are making us all pay extra while our neighbors with solar are enjoying lower electric bills. But Brad and the CalSA team crunched those numbers, and they say the solar cost shift is extremely inflated.
There are a number of ways where they have faulty math to justify their attacks. And it's really very creative how they have built this methodology and storyline that has sunk in with a lot of policymakers. And they push it so hard and in such a widespread fashion that it's difficult to counter.
It's not just California. The nonprofit Solar United Neighbors compiled numerous studies from Mississippi to Maine to Nevada and found little or no evidence to support the utility's cost shift case for solar. And look, I'm not going to say that the cost shift is non-existent, but based on what we've heard from multiple experts and independent studies, it's pretty evident that it's not as high as utilities are making it out to be. And as the Solar Rights Alliance puts it, utilities are lying about rooftop solar to cover their butts.
People are catching on to that fact, and the data is pretty clear how much their spending has increased. And to deflect attention away from them, they had come up with this elaborate cost shift story saying solar customers aren't to blame.
Brad says one of the biggest holes in the cost shift theory is that when homes generate their own electricity, they help offset the power demand.
Normally, you expand the grid in order to serve a higher peak load. We've kept peak load constant, yet they're spending three times as much money as they did.
Utilities are painting solar owners as the scapegoat for high rates, but really, it's the opposite. Research shows that rooftop solar saved California ratepayers $1.5 billion in 2024 alone.
We're really taking weight off the grid and causing them to build less infrastructure, hurting their profits. This utility playbook is playing out across the country.
It all comes down to simple supply and demand. Utilities are in the business of generating electricity and selling it to us. When you produce your own electricity with solar, that threatens their business model and their large paychecks. But if more utilities worked with clean energy rather than against it, we'd all enjoy a break in our bills.
Hey, we might be able to do this for one-tenth the cost if we just add residential batteries on that circuit.
And that's what we're talking about on the next episode of Plugged In, how more battery storage, distributed generation, and virtual power plants can help solve our expensive energy crisis. And if those words don't mean anything to you, don't worry, I'll explain everything. As for this episode, to try and simply answer the question why your electric bill is so high, it's because our power grid is old and overloaded. And the way that most utilities are fixing it is akin to slapping a very expensive Band-Aid on a gaping wound, and we're all paying for the Band-Aid. A big thanks to our experts, Jigar, Jesse, and Brad. Go ahead and hit subscribe so you can stay plugged in.